Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to FY21 earnings conference call of International Conveyors Limited. This conference call may contain forward-looking statements about the company, which are based on the beliefs, opinions, and expectations of the company as on date of this call. These statements are not the guarantees of future performance and involve risks and uncertainties that are difficult to predict. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this call conference is being recorded. And now in the conference, over to Mr. Naveen Agarwal from SKP Securities. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to the maiden earnings call of International Conveyors Limited, hosted by SKP Securities Limited. We have with us Mr. R.K. Dabriwala, Managing Director, Mr. Surbit Dabriwala, Director, Mr. Prasad Deshpande, President, Mr. Udit Sethia, Director, and Mr. Ashok Kumar Gulgulia, CFO. I would now like to welcome Mr. R.K. Dabriwala, Managing Director, to give his opening remarks, a brief introduction of the company, strategies, and growth prospects going forward. This will be followed by a brief on operational and financial performance for the year ended 31st March 2021 by Mr. Prasad Deshpande, post which we will open the floor for questions and answers. I now hand over the call to Mr. Dabriwala for his opening remarks. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Hello and good morning, everyone. First and foremost, I hope you all are keeping safe and healthy during these unprecedented times. I would urge all of you to adhere to the guidelines issued by the central and respective state government to fight COVID. Today on the call, I am joined by Mr. Prasad Deshpande, President, and Orient Capital, our investor relations partners. I would start by thanking all the stakeholders for showing faith and continued support in International Conveyors and also SKP Securities Limited for participating, for parenting us for this investor conference call. We have uploaded our updated investor desk and result highlight on the stock exchanges and company website. I hope everybody had an opportunity to go through the same. Since this is our maiden earning call, let me share a brief overview about International Conveyors, its journey so far, and the growth strategies and opportunities going forward. ICL was founded in 1973 and started its production in 1979 to address the then prevailing pain point of India's coal mining sector. Today, it is India's only listed player in PVC conveyor belting, a critical industrial consumable for mining and bulk transportation. From being primarily a domestic player serving just the coal sector, the painfully hard work done over the years is now bearing fruits. Now, the majority of our revenue comes from exports to developed economies like Canada and USA, primarily serving potash sector with some marquee global customers. We act as a one-stop solution for being a belting requirement for mining and bulk transportation. Let me take a couple of minutes on the mining industry and prospect ahead. We believe that the domestic mining industry is at inflection point. With favorable mining policies and regulations implemented in recent years, with increase in the private sector participation, Indian mining industry with latest infrastructure will be created with high level of mechanization and automation. We envisage that there will be a gradual demand surge for user segment. We are also optimistic of global demand for our various user segments like potash miners. As per the industry reports, global potash demand is increasing and is estimated to grow at 3.5% to 4.5% as compared to 1.5 to 2% previously. Canada contributes approximately 33% of the total potash production, and International Conveyor is the leading supplier with majority of the market share in Canada in potash industry. I am of the opinion that with decent replacement demand, reputed domestic and international clientele base, R&D capabilities to adapt to changes and meet the requirement of the customer, increasing product and customer portfolio, and penetration into the newer graphics, we are well placed to cater and benefit from the opportunities lies ahead of us. Long-standing relationship with domestic and international customers and customer stickiness being an inherent character of this business. Going forward, ICL has a growing revenue visibility with decent margins. We produce twice the amount of renewable energy that we consume through our five windmills, forming an insignificant portion of our revenue. I would now like our president, Mr. Prashad Deshpande, to share with you a little bit about the manufacturing progress and take you through the operational and financial highlights for financial year 21. Prashad Deshpande.
Yeah, hi, good morning, everyone. So just to talk about the operations and financials of ICL, we have two fully integrated manufacturing facilities, one in Aurangabad, Maharashtra, and other in Palta, which is a part of SEZ in West Bengal, with inherent advantages. With 4 decades of experience in manufacturing of solid woven belting for both underground and above ground applications, our team is capable of developing full in-house designs, starting from preliminary design to the final design, and then manufacturing. Over the years, we have been able to develop an extensive range of products of international quality, superior technology, and testing capabilities. This PVC conveyor belting industry has a significant entry barriers like individual facility-wise approvals, a country-wise regulatory approval, and customer-wise approval, all of which can be taken upward almost up to 3 years. Products have been manufactured as per the need and the specifications of the customer and also as per the norms laid down by the regulatory authorities of the respective countries. The product approval and gestation period become a lengthy process, giving us a competitive advantage to grab most of the market share from the opportunity arising. Alongside, we are also the only Indian player delivering global quality standard with all safety and precautionary tests and quality checks. Now coming to financials, we have witnessed a record performance for financial year 21. Revenue grew by 72% and stood at rupees 169.3 crores as compared to 98.7 crores in financial year 20. For financial year 21, our domestic revenue grew by 137% to rupees 26.4 crores from previous 11.1 crores, and revenue from export grew 90% to rupees 139.9 crores as compared to 73.8 crores in financial year 20. The split between the domestic and export is 17 to 83. For domestic segment, coal industry contributed the dominant share of revenue of around 90%, and key customers includes Coal India and all subsidiaries, Tata Steel, JSW and Singrani. However, we have made inroads into various other sectors like crusher industry, cement, and we have started supplying to Sri Cement in financial year 21. We are optimistic of adding more customers across industries in the domestic market, giving us high revenue visibility going forward. For export segment, 92% of the revenue came from the potash industry and balance from coal and other industrial applications. Country-wise, 89% of the revenue came from Canada and 10% from USA. We are now developed products as per the global standards, and we are making efforts to penetrate into a newer geographies. Our EBITDA for financial year 21 stood to 19.9 crores as compared to 6.7 crores for financial year 20, a growth of almost 197%. EBITDA margin for financial year 21 stood at 11.8% as compared to 6.8% in financial year 20, a growth of 500 BPS. Our PAT for financial year 21 stood at 16.6 crores as compared to 6.4 crores in financial year 20, a growth of almost 161% on year-to-year basis. Our PAT margins have improved from 6.5% to 9.8% in financial year 21. A few more balance sheet highlights. Our borrowings as on 31st March 2021 stood at 45.6 crores as compared to 62.9 crores at the end of financial year 20. Our net debt to equity ratio for financial year 21 stood at 0.3. With increasing profitability, our ROC as on 31st March 2021 stood at 13.6%. To conclude, we would like to highlight that with the growth in the demand for our products on the back of growing mining industry, we have anticipating a huge replacement demand, strong order book positions we have. We are also working on entering into the newer geographies and newer sectors. And we are also working on developing a new products. So based on this, ICL is highly placed to address the growing industry demand. Now I open the floor for any question, answers and discussion.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may please press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question, you may please press star and one now. The first question is from the line of Anish Shah from Wellgrow Investment. Please go ahead.
What is the life of the product and is there any replacement demand?
Yes, basically when we talk about this product, which is a PVC conveyor belting, the life can be anything between 3 to 5 years because there are two types of belts which goes for underground. One is the extensible, having life of 3 years, whereas the mainline belt is around 5 years. But that also depends on the structure which is being employed by the miners. Because if your structures are good, even the life can go up to 6 years and 7 years.
And any breakup of revenue demand is available from new demand and replacement demand?
As on date, I don't have that, but we can present that during our next call.
Okay, and what is the size of order book and expected execution time?
See, generally, for example, if you talk about the exports, the manufacturing time is close to around 12 weeks and then maybe 4 to 8 weeks on a water.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as order book is concerned, as on date, we have close to around 45 crore order book.
Okay. And last question, apart from coal industries and potash industries, which other industries will be a major contributor to our revenue?
See, for example, as we were explaining, we had recently started supplies to the cement industry. We are also working closely with the crusher industries as well as waste management industries.
Okay.
And we are also working overseas for with some gypsum, copper and other metal mining.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Menon Mehta from Medline Security. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir, for the opportunity. So I have a few questions, sir. So who will be our top customers in the domestic and export markets currently, and what would be the revenue contribution for these customers for the last 2 years?
See, as far as domestic is concerned, our major customers are Coal India and all its subsidiaries, as well as Singrani Collieries and Tata Steel. As far as exports are concerned, basically we are supplying it to the world's largest potash industries.
Okay, and what would be the contribution, sir, revenue contribution? So in terms of, say, percentages for the last, for FY21 and for FY20 also?
See, for example, as far as domestic is concerned, of total revenue, the contribution with these three customers could be close to around 80-85%. And as far as exports is concerned, we are talking about the potash, which should be close to around 85%.
Okay. So have you added any new customers in the last 2 years?
Yeah, for example, if we talk about exports, and as far as exports are concerned, we added two new customers in last 2 years. One was in USA and other is in Canada.
Okay.
Apart from our existing customers.
Absolutely. But their contribution will be very low, since you're saying that 85% is of both businesses, domestic and exports, come from the top three. So how much would that contribute, sir?
See, generally what happens...
The new addition in the last 2 years?
See, generally what happens once we start supplying the belt to the new client, it takes at least one and a half years for them to assess the performance, and then the regular order starts. So definitely the percentage revenue from those clients are going to go up in coming years.
Okay. And any targets for those for the next couple of years?
Yes, we have some internal targets, but I'm not able to quantify right now.
Okay, but the revenue share will go up for these customers.
Exactly.
Okay. So just a couple of more questions, if I may. So what would be our utilizations currently, and how much more can we use these capacities still?
For this particular product, I mean, it's really difficult to talk about the capacity utilization, because capacity utilization depends on your product mix. For example, if we talk about type 3 belt, your production is going to be high, but if you talk about type 12 belt, your production is going to be low. But given product mix, as on date, we are close to 75-80%.
Okay, fine. Got it, sir. If I have any more questions, I'll get back into the queue. Thank you.
A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Simran Bakaria from SKP Securities. Please go ahead.
Hello. Good afternoon, sir. We know that the company is exposed to the volatility of in the prices of the raw material. So how is the increase in the raw material passed on to the customer? Does this happen with the time lag, or we just pass it on? Like, how do we do it?
Hello. Yeah, when we talk about the raw material, so would you like to answer?
Prashad, you answer.
Right, sir, I'll do that. And yeah, when we talk about the raw material fluctuations, see, for example, if we talk about the domestic, all business is basically on a tender base. So whenever the tender is open, you have to bid for that tender, and then the reverse auction takes place, and then the final orders are placed. So as far as domestic is concerned, during the tender, we always take care of our pricing based on the raw material pricing. As far as exports are concerned, it's also on an order-to-order base, so we always take care about increase or decrease in the raw material. With few clients where we have a long-term contract of 3 years to 5 years, mutually what we have decided, we are working on some internationally accepted indices. And then based on those indices movement, we either increase the price or reduce the price. And that changes we do on a 6-monthly basis. So with this methodology, we are covered with both, either increase of raw material or reduction in raw material prices.
Okay. And so what is the proportion of the raw material that we import?
See, for example, I'm out of my total requirement of raw material, maybe I'm importing close to around 35% of the raw material. But for those imports also, I have indigenous substitutes also available and developed.
So are we looking to source this domestically, or we'll continue importing?
No, it will continue both ways, domestic as well as imports, because we don't want to have a dependency only on one. So we always, for all raw materials, we always have minimum 2 to 3 players.
Okay. And so how is the impact of the freight cost currently that is prevailing in the market? Like, we have seen that freight costs have increased substantially. So how did this impact our cost?
Yeah, definitely. For example, generally when we do our export, the business model is on a two type. One is called as a DDP. That means our responsibility lies till the material reaches to the mine site. And other is on a FOB basis, that our responsibility lies up to the Mumbai or Calcutta port. So as far as FOB basis is concerned, I mean, it's not impacting us, but definitely where there is a DDP basis, increased freight cost is impacting, and we are able to pass on that to our customers, because now it has become a global phenomena, so customer also is aware about the freight cost, so we are able to pass that to the customer.
Okay, sir. Okay, so one or two questions more. So what is your guidance on the working capital requirement of, like, we have known that this industry is working capital intensive in nature. So what is the average working capital days of ICL?
I think Mr. W. Wala, would you like to answer?
Yeah. You see, it is like this, that we took this into account, because what happens that when we ship the material is on water for about 6 to 8 weeks, and then the customer also takes about 30 to 45 days for payment. So the requirement would be huge as far as working capital is concerned. So when we cut our deal with our suppliers, we gave them some discount for making us payment immediately when the material is on ship. We give our invoices to them, and within 5 days the payment comes. So we have been able to control our working capital requirement to great extent. As far as domestic demand is concerned, it takes about a month to 45 days by Coal India or Sagrani to make the payment to us. So I would say that the kind of limit we have from our bankers, that is sufficient to take care of our working capital requirement. Only during this price volatility period, we are trying to keep some more stock. So naturally, there is a slightly higher raw material stock. And so to that extent, the requirement is more, but the banks have been able to give us the facility for that.
So what would be the average inventory holding period for the company for both the raw materials and the finished goods? If you could give us a number.
We keep minimum 2 months inventory for raw material. And as far as finished goods is concerned, it's a tailor-made product, so we don't keep any inventory. As soon as the material is made, the material is shipped.
Okay, sir. And so just a couple of more questions. So what is our CAPEX plan in the near future? If you could just share some details.
Pardon? Hello?
So CAPEX plans, your future CAPEX plans.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Hello?
Could you repeat this question, please?
Plan that you are going to undertake in the near
you see, it depends. It depends. You see, as Mr. Prasad told, that we are using about 75% of our capacity. If we are required to use more capacity, at that point of time, we might add some more capex. At the moment, I don't think we need more capex, because our Falta plant has just come into operation in about last 2 years only, 3 years only. So we have enough capacity for the time being.
Okay. And so we in the balance sheet, we see that there is a non-current investments, like about 170 crore for FY21. So, and majority of this is exposure to Elpro International Limited. So any, are we looking to liquidate these investments, or are we going to continue to hold such a big chunk in the investments?
You see, as it is, this has given us a huge kind of profit in our balance sheet, so to say, that at the price which we bought and the price today, there is a huge difference in the prices. And well, you see, whenever we would need more money, we would certainly unload, but till then, we are keeping it with ourselves.
Okay. And just last question, sir. So, can you brief us about the working of the subsidiaries that we have, four subsidiaries? So, can you just give a brief of the workings of these subsidiaries and their overall performance, contribution towards the company?
You see, we have three subsidiaries. One is in Singapore, and the step-down subsidiary is in Australia, and another subsidiary is in America. And the subsidiary in America is doing pretty well. And Australian subsidiary, we are re-energizing, and we are trying to re-enter that market, because that is one of the biggest coal mining markets. And to enter into that market, you need to have some presence there.
Okay. And so what about International Belting Limited and Conveyor Holdings Private Limited?
International Belting, we had a plan of going into a different kind of product, but we didn't go, and so it is kind of a dormant company at the moment, and we have not decided what to do with that.
Okay. Thank you, sir. That would be enough on my end. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pankaj Gupta from Ratnabali Investments. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I have some questions from the industry side. So when you say that we are the largest player of PVC belting and only player in India, I just wanted to understand the overall
only listed player.
So we just wanted to understand what is the overall market size of our products in India and globally, and how does our products differ from this rubber belting, which is also used in mining industries, and who are our global and Indian competitors in this space?
You see, first of all, let me clarify this, that Indian mining industry, the rubber belting is not allowed underground. You see, the rubber belting can be used above ground, means on the surface. But for underground use, because PVC belting is a fire-resistant, anti-static belting, so for underground only you can use PVC belting. But basically, you see, when we are saying that we are in this segment, which is underground mining belting, then basically that sector rubber can't come in. And there are very few manufacturers all over the world of PVC mining conveyor belt. And we are in good company like Michelin, which has taken over Defena and Conti. They are our competitors.
Sorry, once again, can you just name Michelin and Continental?
Pardon?
Sir, can you just again please name the companies, global, and can you please again repeat
Michelin, Michelin.
Name of the company?
The name of the company is Michelin.
Okay.
They have taken over the Fenner. The Michelin is one of the biggest tire company. They have taken over the Fenner UK, which is a building company, and Conti International, a German company. So what I'm saying that we are in good company, that we are competing with these two multinational giants.
And sir, any other Indian unlisted company?
Well, there might be in some unorganized sector, but nothing to mention about. And generally, we don't talk about our competitors. We talk about ourselves only.
Okay. And sir, could you also help us? What is the global market size for our product? How big or small are we? Say we have say around 170 crores of turnover. So this would be with respect to the
very difficult to say because we have only touched two sectors, namely potash and coal. We are now going into a new sector which is salt, and all these are very very huge sectors. So to say what is the total global demand, it's very, very difficult for me to say.
Okay. And sir, what has led to such an increase in our top line and bottom line in the year FY21, if you could say it? And does we work on order booking? And if it is, what would be our order book size right now?
See, as Shah, in his opening remark, he stated that this product is a product where you really the supplier come to know after having used your material for 5 to 7 years. So we have been supplying to potash for last 5 to 7 years. But then suddenly they decided that, okay, the total demand they want to place on us. And that is how suddenly this increase between 20 and 21 took place. And further, we feel that now since we have this year, from this year onwards, we have started supplying to salt, the same situation would be there in next 2 to 3 years' time.
Okay. Okay. And sir, just last question. Can you tell us, is there any import duty in India for this PVC belting if somebody wants to import?
No, I think nobody can compete from foreign countries the kind of prices which we quote in Coal India and Singhalani. So earlier Chinese companies tried, but they couldn't succeed. So basically no one is there.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We would request the participants to please press star and 1 to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Dinesh Kotecha from CRIC. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Dinesh Kotecha. Thanks for giving this opportunity. So I was just going through your financials, and I found that in the total turnover of 166 crores, 40% turnover came from December quarter, from Q3, and 30% has come from Q4. But Q3, our operating margin was 27.7% and net profit margin was nearly 19%. Now that has been reduced to 11.94 in the Q4 And I mean, can you explain me this particular so Q2, Q3 to Q4, the slide in the margins?
Yeah, actually the spurt in the raw material came only during that period of time, especially the kind of raw material which we buy for the making of belting. And that was unprecedented. The spurt was unprecedented. And similarly, you see, wherever our sale was DDP, means on CIF basis, the we were hit very badly by the freight, which increased like nobody's business. You see, it's about more than 100% or so.
What is the scenario that you have undergone in this first 2.5 months now for this particular point?
I think we have recovered the ground because we took the matter up with our purchasers and brought to their notice about this freight increase. And to some extent, we have been given the relief of that. And similarly, as far as raw material is concerned. So, thanks.
So do you think that the margins of December can be again got in this any of the quarters in this year?
I could you repeat your question?
The margins which we achieved in December quarter, 27.7% in OPM and 19% in NPM. Can we achieve that? Is that possible again in this, any of the quarters in this current year?
I won't be able to say this at the moment. Because
sir, my next question is that you just answered to somebody earlier person's question that we are working at 75% capacity and there is no capex as such. That means full capacity, we'll be able to turn about 225 crores. Next, what after taking the 225 crores? What is the next plan for expansion or growth?
Yeah, you see, we think we can go up to 250 crores with the present capacity. And again, it depends upon the mix of the product. You see, if we cater only to the higher size of the building, still we can go up to 300 crores.
But are we planning, is there something on the anvil right now to plan for further expansion after 300 crores or 250 crores? So strategic planning is going on long term?
At the moment, first we want to achieve that within a year or so, and only then we would start working on that.
Sir, next question is Aurangabad and Falda. I mean, do we have sufficient land for expansion now to put up a new factory or expansion of the factory?
No. I would say that's our constraint.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Sintu Joy, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Can you please get me some update on your disinvestment plans? Like you mentioned that the board has approved for your stake sale in Elpo International.
Yeah. We that is an enabling resolution we have passed to the board.
And any updates on your NSE listing?
Pardon?
Any updates on your NSE listing plans?
Prashad, would you go through this? I couldn't get this, actually.
Listing of your stocks in NSE?
So he's asking about the NSE listing plan.
Yeah. Energy?
NSE, National Stock Exchange listing plan.
Well, this question is not clear to me. Prashad, would you like to take this question?
Yeah, basically...
Hello.
Yeah, we are in the process of NSE listing.
Okay. Yes, fine, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. We would request the participants to please press star and one to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Sarvesh Budani from an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Hi. Sir, you mentioned that the competition in our products is very small. So is there any reason why competition is so less? Because you said the opportunity size is pretty big. So is it some availability of raw material or is it just client relationships? So if you could share anything on that.
See, if you recall our starting discussion, mainly when you talk about this particular product, it's having multiple barriers of dual approval from the customer and then the government authorities. Secondly, even the whole process takes maybe 2 to 3 years. And once you put the belt, and then the real performance is understood only after 3-4 years. So the gestation period is very high. That's why people are, no new entrants are coming into this.
Okay, okay. And sir, on the gross margin or EBITDA margin side, could you guide on any steady state margins? Because quarter on quarter, it is very volatile, our EBITDA margins. So what could be the steady state margin? Would it be 15%, 12%, 20%?
Sir, would you like to answer?
You see, again, as this product is based on the raw material prices, so the margin would also be actually based on that. So we can't predict the raw material prices. But I would say that, you see, overall, the yearly margin, whatever you see, what you have seen in last year, I think we would be able to come up to that.
Okay, sir. And sir, could you throw any light on how would be our asset turn? So let's say we invest, whenever we do our capex, so if we invest 10 crores, what could be the peak revenue out of that, or what is the thumb rule in our industry? Anything on that aspect?
Could you please elaborate your question?
No, sir. So let's say we invest some amount in our business. So say we invest 10 crores for capacity expansion. So how much revenue can we generate out of it? So what is basically what I'm saying, that on our net gross fixed assets, what is the kind of peak revenue we do and what is the kind of investment we need to do to get there?
See, investment, again, would totally depend upon what kind of market we are getting. See, the total, if suppose somebody wants to put up this kind of plant today,
right,
it would cost him about 100 to 150 crores.
Okay, okay. And for us, the cost will be lower or will it be similar?
It would be much lower.
So how much lower, if you could say? Is 50%, 60%, just any rough estimate?
Yeah, about 50%.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Because you see, again, everything is tailor-made. Nothing is off the shelf. No machine of this product would come off the shelf.
Thank you, sir, and all the best.
Hello. Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question, you may please press star and one now. We would request the participants to please press star and one to ask a question. As there are no further questions, I would now like to
hand over the conference over to Mr. Surbit Dabriwala for closing comments.
I think it's for Mr. RK Dabriwala.
I'd like to say that thank you so much for.
We would like to highlight. To conclude, we would like to highlight that mining industry in India and across the globe is growing, and so is the need for PVC conveyor belting. More so for underground mining and covered overground mining, where ICF's products are used. Our capabilities to cater multiple industries, giving us strong growth visibility for the future. I hope we have been able to answer all your queries. In case you require any further details, you may please contact us or Orient Capital, our investor relations partners. With this, I conclude the call for today and looking forward for regular such engagement with you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank everyone for joining us. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of International Conveyors Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you everyone for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.